I still can't imagine that we're seeing a 7% interest rates, but are they going to go any higher? So that's what our agenda is for this week. Because why? Well, the big focal point this week is the Federal Reserve meeting. So they're going to meet this week, and then they're going to come out on Wednesday and tell us exactly what their plans are. So we're sitting in anticipation watching for that. Another piece of this is I want to introduce. I just had an interview with Jaspreet Singh of Minority Mindset. If you don't know him, you got to check him out. The guy is fantastic. I did a collaboration with him, and those videos are coming out today and tomorrow to prep you guys for the Federal Reserve meeting. So don't forget to check that one out. Jaspreet has over 1.4 million subscribers. I tracked this guy down for 2 years. He finally agreed to do some interviews with me, and you're going to be privileged to see those videos that I did with him, asking him questions that I would expect you guys to ask. So without further ado, let's get over to the headlines. We see in the headlines, U.S. Treasury yields climb as investors look toward November's Fed meeting. So what's going on right now? Well, like I said, the Federal Reserve meeting is this week. Then they're going to come out on Wednesday and tell us exactly what they're going to do. The trend right now is they're increasing rates by 75 basis points. It's unprecedented in the past. So you can see in the headlines here is November's Fed meeting preview. Officials set to approve the fourth massive rate hike while eyeing the next steps. So what the anticipation is they're going to increase rates this week by 0.75%. It's going to make everything more expensive, from mortgages to cars to credit cards to personal loans. So what is the Fed's goals now going after this meeting? What are they expected to do going forward? Well, a lot of economists are saying they're going to increase rates again in December by 0.5%. That would put us as the largest one-year increases ever in history. So the only time's going to tell with that. But as I said, check out my videos coming out today and tomorrow with Jaspreet Singh, because that's what we talk. We talk Fed and real estate in video one. Then in video two, I try to ask the questions you guys would have. Where do you put your money in this economy? Where do you put your money in this cycle of the business cycle? So that's what's coming up. But let's get over to the headline news. That's what you're here for. We have nothing today. There's usually isn't much coming out on the news for Monday, but Tuesday and Wednesday this week is what we're anticipating. Right here, Tuesday, we have the JOLTS index. That's how many job openings there are. Well, the Federal Reserve's concerned with that because they have two mandates. One is price stability, aka inflation, and the other is jobs. So they don't really want to crash the job market by lowering inflation because they have two mandates, not just one. They want to kind of have a soft landing in the economy without really crushing the employment numbers. But the biggest news we have this week is coming out on Wednesday. It's a slew of information, but we come out down at the bottom here. We come out with the Federal Reserve comes out on Wednesday and tells us exactly what they're going to do. And again, the anticipation is they're going to increase rates again by 0.75%. So again, I have Jaspreet Singh coming on my show later today, but we did a pre-recording and you're going to see him as well as tomorrow. And you can check out tons of his videos right here. He has more than me on video wise, and he has lots more than me subscribers at 1.4 million. So find out why 1.4 million people are following Jaspreet Singh. Just watch my video later today. You'll get it. So the next piece of this puzzle is where in the heck are mortgage rates going right now with no economic news coming out? We see the MBS market kind of crumbling a little bit. What you're seeing in front of you right now is the mortgage-backed security bond that trades on Wall Street. This bond is the biggest piece of the mortgage puzzle, okay, of your mortgage rate. Okay, so the yield on this mortgage-backed security bond is the biggest part or component of your mortgage rate. Okay, so that's why we really follow this. We don't really follow the treasuries and anything else because it's this bond, this particular bond that controls interest rates. Okay, so what you're seeing on your screen right now is what's going on with the price of the bond. It has an inverse relationship of what's going on with the rates. So you see on your screen that the price of the bond is going down. It's down 38 ticks right now. That means rates are going to go up. They'll go up about probably 5 or 8 basis points, which aren't much, but it's a little bit of a trickle up. But you can see down below that the trend for going down has been going on for about a year now, pushing rates up from, let's see where the mortgage rates are right now so I can give you a gauge on where we were and where we are today. This cell right here, these are mortgage rates published by Mortgage News Daily. You see the 30-year fixed used to be 3, now it's 7. So it's over double where we started basically the year. So this is where you see mortgage rates. I have this link down below. These are mortgage rates published by Mortgage News Daily. They do it every day. So I just want to show you these rates. Why do we show you this rate? Well, I'm trying to get you guys to figure out or understand where rates are. This is the national averages, okay? So we follow this just to get, like, if you're watching the stock market, you want to see what stocks are doing, you watch the Dow Jones or the NASDAQ. So this is basically like that. But for you buying individual stocks or for you looking for your own particular mortgage rate, how do you do that? How do you know what your mortgage rate is? Well, what you do is you go to therateupdate.com right here. We can help you with this. We are a mortgage broker. We're actually a bank, but we act as a broker. What I mean by that is we're a bank. We are a federally chartered bank licensed throughout the whole country. We have checking and savings and everything else. But we also broker out our loans to over 85 of the country's largest banks and lenders, mortgage lenders. How do you do this? How do you let us find you or help you find the lowest rate in the country? Well, it's pretty simple. We're going to start live events this Wednesday. We're going to go over loan estimate reviews. What is a loan estimate? Well, basically, when you apply for a mortgage, what happens is you apply for the mortgage, and within 3 business days, the bank has to send you out disclosures. Well, part of that disclosure package is your loan estimate. The loan estimate breaks down the whole loan for you. It gives you all the questions that you would need to know to find out, can you get a better rate? So what it tells us is what the value of the house is, what your loan amount is, what kind of loan it is, what the fees are, what the rate is it locked in, all this stuff, okay? So if you have one of those, most people say, hey, shop around and get 2 or 3 of these. Well, go ahead and do that. Then let's make meme your final stop. What I need you to do or what you should be doing, taking that loan estimate and making sure your other lender gives you the best foot forward, their best quote, because we're not going to go back to them unless they can beat what my final numbers come out at. So here's what we're going to do. You're going to get your best estimate from that lender. Okay. Then you're going to come to therateupdate.com. You're going to go over here and you're going to click loan estimate. This is a free review that we have. You're going to go down through and answer the questions. And I know a lot of you guys don't want to get phone calls and texts and emails and everything else. So I put this in there. How do you want us to get a hold of you? And that's how we'll do that. Okay. What you're going to do is go down through here and fill this all out. Then you're going to drag and drop any of the loan estimates you have right into here. Remember, I want the best foot forward from your other lenders because we don't want to go back and forth and back and forth and back and forth. Have them give you the best quote, throw it in here. Then we're going to analyze this to over 84 different lenders throughout the entire country to make sure they are giving you the best terms. And if they're not, we'll make sure we get those for you. So that's it for today, guys. So don't forget, we're going to be posting a video in about an hour or two with me and Jaspreet Singh. And we're going to talk about the Fed, real estate, stocks, other investments. You're going to learn a lot this week. So if you like my channel and you find value in it, all I ask you to do is give us a thumbs up, subscribe down below, hit the bell every time I post a video, you get an alert. Take care, guys. God bless. I'll see you soon.